Now, name the event in which Baron de Coubertin won his own Olympic medal. Who was Baron de Coubertin?
Was he the one who reinvented the Olympic Games?
Yeah, he's known as the father of the modern Olympic movement. Yeah.
And so he obviously set up one event that he's the only person who did, so that he could win it.
To give him credit, he did it anonymously.
Ah. So that's why he's wearing a false moustache.
How many events can you enter anonymously?
Not too many, I suppose.
Exactly. But,
so it's only something when you're hidden. You
don't need to be seen.
It's a race between pantomime horses, and he was the back end of one of the winning horses.
It's not as absurd as it sounds. I mean, there were some really odd Olympic events at the beginning.
You're completely hidden?
Well...
Tunnelling. Olympic tunnelling.
You're thinking of physical things, aren't you? The Olympic Games was wider than that.
So, essay writing or poem composing?
Poem is the answer.
Ah.
He won the gold medal for poetry.
Excellent. Shut up.
Oh, you think that's weird? All the way up to 1948, there was a gold medal for town planning in the Olympics.
Won by Milton Keynes.
Lost by Milton Keynes, you would imagine. But no, there were all kinds of artistic categories. There was sculpture, music, painting, literature.
Sculpture. And look at him go, the young Greek. The young Greek's mallet is flying.
The oldest ever medal winner was a silver medal winner, aged 73, in the 1948 engravings and etchings event.
And that's fantastic.
He was a Briton called John Copley. In 1900, there was a woman who won possibly the oddest event, a farmer's wife. It was the poodle clipping event. She trimmed 17 poodles in 2 hours.
Yes.
Can you imagine? She got a gold medal for it.
I'm sure she did, 17 in 2 hours. That's impressive even to me.
Yeah, isn't it? But do you know the reason they stopped doing the sculpture and the painting and the poetry and everything else?
It was something to do with the...
Drugs.
Drugs and the sex test.
No, the reason they stopped was because they felt that it rather compromised the idea of amateurism, because it's basically all the artists and things would carry on being artists for the rest of the year, whereas the other Olympians, those who threw javelins, they held down other jobs.